10. Today we are going to start with another book, that is Footprints Without Feet. And in this book we are going to start with the chapter Footprints Without Feet. Chapter it is, you can say the name of the book, it is on this chapter. So what is Footprints Without Feet? This is actually not a complete story, Footprints Without Feet. This is just an excerpt, means piece of writing, which has been taken from the famous novel, The Invisible. Right, absolutely right. Have you read it? Yes, very interesting one. So you know, this is one of the most famous book, or in this is the most famous story in sci-fi, you can say series, right? So there, like that, first of all, the first sci-fi novel was, that was written by H.G. Wells, Time Machine. So in the line of that only, right? So when this Invisible Man was written, so whatever the Hindi movies or English movies like Mr. India was there, they are all inspired from this kind, these kind of books. Because this concept, it was where, first of all, it was introduced in the novels only, and then it has been picturized and it has been turned into movies, right? So this Invisible Man, who was that? How he became invisible? Can anybody tell? You have read Invisible Man? Little bit, Raghav? You have read? Huh, what happened there? Yes, actually he was experimenting on the formula of invisibility. So he has made a potion, means liquid syrup, of combination of different kind of liquids. And after, you can say, drinking that, he turned out to be invisible. Okay, so but was he a hero of this novel ultimately? Because he had made a rare invention, so was he a hero? Why he was not a hero? Yes? No. If you read the novel, you will come to know that he has undergone wrong ways after, you can say, inventing this formula. He has not utilized his formula for the betterment of the people, but he has utilized it for many wrongdoings. He has committed theft, he has committed robbery, he has killed a man, he is, you can see, he's an outlawed person who has broken many laws. At one time he's after the constable also, and he has thrown him out of the bar. So this scientist, whose name was Griffin, okay, so when he invented this formula, as he was not paying the rent of his house also, so what he has done, he has also set his own house on fire so that the people will think that he is dead. Okay, so ultimately in the actual novel, what happens, that he was dead, he was murdered at the end. Not murdered, he was killed by the police officer. Because number of burglaries, number of problems he was creating in the city. And ultimately what happened, that the police was after him. But because he was invisible, they were not able to catch him. But finally, you know that bad things doesn't prevail for longer time. So ultimately what happened, in the end, he was caught by the police officer and ultimately he was murdered. He was killed there. So this is what exactly, he is no longer the hero of the story. Although he is endowed with great intelligence, but he has not utilized his intelligence in for humanity, for human ways. So in this chapter, Griffin, who has come to Iping, is the name of place where he has rented a room in an inn, where the rooms are given to you for living for some days after paying rent. And ultimately, how Mr. and Mrs. Halls, who were the owners of the inn, they felt about his strange ways, and how he made himself visible and ultimately thrown everyone into hysterics. This we are going to read. Okay, we're going to read. So there are many humorous incidents also, of course, in this chapter. Moreover, a point of seriousness is also raised by the writer. That what are the qualities of a good human being? What are the qualities of a hero? Although he has invented the formula of invisibility, but still he was not the hero of the story. And this is what we are going to read. Okay, so let us concentrate upon the chapter. Yes, here it is displayed on the screens also. If you are having the books, you can have it. And rest, I am reading. The two boys started in surprise at the fresh, muddy footprints of a pair of bare feet. So the two boys, they were moving through the streets of London, and what they have visioned, what they have seen, that in the snow, muddy footprints are appearing from nowhere. They were surprised. Why they were surprised? Because no man was walking upon the snow, and ultimately, without someone's walking, how these footprints are being produced? This was the thing of interest for them. What was a barefooted man doing on the steps of a house in the middle of London, and where was the man? So the two boys, they were surprised to see that without a man, these footprints are being produced. The man was to be seen nowhere, and what this barefooted man, because in London that was the time of winter when no one could go out without wearing the clothes, and moreover barefoot means walking on the snow, it's not an easier job at that time. So they were thinking that how this man, what this man is doing in the middle of London at this time. As they gazed, a remarkable sight met their eyes. A fresh footmark appeared from nowhere. So they were closely looking, gaze means to have a close look towards the footprints, and then what happened? A fresh footprint appeared in front of them. Naturally, they were thinking that this can be a ghost, because from where this footprint is emerging, from where it is produced, this was the thing of surprise for them, because the man was not seen anywhere, and from where these footprints are being produced. Further, footprints followed one after another and descending the steps and progressing down the street. The boys followed fascinated until the muddy impressions became fainter and fainter and at last disappeared altogether. So what happened further? These footprints followed. They were following those footprints. One after another footprint, they have been produced. And then descending them, they were moving down the street. Then what happened? These boys were so fascinated. They were so amazed to see these footprints, because this was really a thing of surprise for them, as from nowhere these footprints, they have been produced. From where it has been produced, this they want to know. This is the reason why the two boys, they were following the footprints they had that have been produced in the snow. And later on, these impressions were turning faint, fainter, and again fainter. And at last, they disappeared altogether. If a man is walking upon the snow, who is producing these footprints, the man is nowhere to be seen. And where the man has gone now? Because the footprints had stopped there, it ended there. What is this? The explanation of the mystery was really simple enough. The bewildered boys, bewildered means confused. The bewildered boys had been following a scientist who had just discovered how to make the human body transparent. So this is nothing, the writer is saying that there is no mystery behind that. It is quite simple, because these footprints were made by the scientist who is intelligent enough and who has produced or who has invented the formula of invisibility, and he is successful in making the human body transparent. right? Griffin, the scientist, had carried out experiment after experiment to prove that the human body could become invisible. Finally, he swallowed certain rare drugs. Rare means which are not commonly found. And his body became as transparent as a sheet of glass, though it also remained as solid as glass. So it means that what was the name? So first of all, what was the name of the scientist? Griffin. Griffin has invented this formula. He has carried out experiment after experiment. You know that success cannot be achieved overnight. Okay? And there is no, you can say, escalator to success. One has to take the stairs to reach there. So it is not like an his overnight, you can success in the achievement of this formula. But he has been doing experiment after experiment. And finally, he has come to the conclusion that he was able to invent the formula of invisibility. How? He became invisible. He swallowed certain rare drugs. He has swallowed these rare drugs. And his body became transparent. His body became transparent as a sheet of glass. But of course, it is not, you can say, it has turned out to be transparent. But it is still as solid as human being. If one can touch it, one can feel that somebody is standing here. Although he is not visible. It has only turned out to be invisible. But another thing is that only the body has turned out to be invisible, not the clothes. If the man is wearing clothes, suppose an invisible man is standing here, you are not able to see that man. If he is wearing the clothes, then what you will feel? That clothes are hanging like in the air. This is what Griffin has done. Okay? Because here there were two problems for him. In order to protect himself from the intense cold weather, which was prevalent in London at that time. And the second thing was that to have a living place. Because as I have told you that after inventing this formula, as he did not have good links, good connections with his landlord. So what he has done? He has set out his house to fire. So there was no place for him to live. He was revengeful in nature. First negative quality of Griffin. As he was revengeful in nature, so this is the reason in order to take revenge from his landlord, he has set his house on fire. So, brilliant scientist though he was, Griffin was rather a lawless person. His landlord disliked him and tried to eject him. Eject him means throw him out of the house. Tell him to sit properly. Sit properly. Next. In revenge, Griffin set fire to the house. I told that his landlord did not like him. And in revenge, what he has done? He has set out his house to fire. To get away without being seen, he had to remove his clothes. And thus it was that he became homeless vendor. So how did Griffin turn out to be a homeless vendor? Because he has set out his fire. And moreover, he has to take off all his clothes because his body, after drinking those rare drugs, it has turned out to be invisible. And ultimately what he has to do, he has to remove his clothes so that nobody could see him because he had no money with him to pay the rent. And where he could live now without money? How he could pay the rent of the house? So, in order to make him invisible, he has to remove all his clothes. And this is what he had done. That was really very difficult for him, and that was the biggest problem for him. How to make himself, you can say, safe. Thus, he became a homeless vendor. This is how he has turned out to be a homeless vendor. Okay? So, he is without clothes, without money, quite invisible, until he happened to step in some mud and left footprints as he walked. So it is only at that time that when he was being invisible, going from one place to another in search of shelter, because he was wearing no clothes, he wanted to protect himself from cold weather. And ultimately what has happened, he has reached a place in the snow where those boys were standing and who has seen his footprints on the snow, and ultimately they were trying to follow. So why were the two boys surprised? Raise up your hands. Because footprints from nowhere appeared in front of him. Yes. Right, there were footprints on the snow. Okay, fine. So what great discovery was made by Griffin? What great discovery was made by Griffin? That he? How okay that he became invisible? But still strong or hard as a sheet of glass. Okay. So what invention he had made? Yes, first desk. What invention he had made? How he has made this invention possible? By swallowing some rare drugs that he had invented. Okay. So why did Griffin turn out to be a homeless vendor? Why Griffin turn out to be a homeless vendor? Yes.
In order to take revenge from his owner, he set the house on fire and left the house.
And he left the house. So in order to save himself, he has taken off his clothes, turned out to be invisible. He was without any money, without any place to live, and he has turned out to be a homeless vendor. Okay? He has turned out to be invisible. So next. He escaped easily enough from the boys who followed his footprints in London. So from those two young boys, he had escaped easily. Because maybe he has gone to a pavement where maybe the snow is cleaned off, and when he is putting his feet there, no footprints are appearing there. So he has gone there, but his adventures were by no means over. But this has not come to his adventures. He is still very adventurous in nature. He wanted to explore more and more. So what happened? He had chosen a bad time of the year to wander about in London without clothes. Why he had chosen it a bad time for in order to walk about in London? Why he had chosen that bad time? He has chosen that bad time because the winter season was in full swing. It is not possible for a man to handle himself without any clothes. And he is moving in that cold winter without clothes. Naturally, what he was looking for? He was looking for a shelter. Okay. He wanted to take shelter somewhere. It was midwinter. The air was bitterly cold and he could not do without clothes. Instead of walking about the streets, he decided to slip him into big London store for warmth. Because it was midwinter, winter season was in full swing. And it was not at all possible for him to cope up in this winter weather. So it was bitterly cold and he could not handle himself without clothes. So where he wanted to go? He wanted to go to a London store in order to get some clothes from there and protect himself. Now let us see how he enters the store. Closing time arrived, and as soon as the doors were shut, Griffin was able to give himself the pleasure of clothing and feeding himself without regard to expense. Yes. So now it was the closing time of the store. He was already in the store. He was just waiting for the people to go away and put the shutters down. Why? Because when he will put his clothes on in order to protect himself, he will turn out to be visible. Okay. But his face wouldn't be visible because it is not covered with clothes. So what happened? He wanted to give himself this feeling of coziness, this feeling of, you can say, this feeling of warmth without any expense, without spending a money. Because what is the problem? Why he was not entering any shop and purchasing the things? Because of the reason that he did not have any money. And on that day, what happened? He did not have any money, but he wanted to have the clothes. So he has chosen the time when it was the closing time of the shops as well as the stores, so that he can enter the store and take the clothing. He broke open boxes, wrappers, and fitted himself out with warm clothes. Soon with shoes and overcoat and a wide-brimmed hat. Wide-brimmed hat means, you know, the hats having a broad brim on the side. You can see in the picture also. He became a fully dressed and visible person. So now he has taken the clothes. He has worn the, you can say, undercovers, including shirt, pant, and then a long overcoat. And on the head, he has that wide-brimmed hat. This afterward he will do, na? Because first of all, he will cover himself with clothes only. Right? I told, na, that his face will be still invisible. That would seem that hat is hanging in the air without any face. How is this possible? So he wanted to look something after that in a theatrical company where he will get all the accessories in order to cover his face with. So we will read afterwards that what he will cover his face with. So what happened? Soon he became a visible person. Now in the kitchen of the restaurant, he found some cold meat and coffee, and it was followed up the meal with sweets and wine taken from the grocery store. And finally, he settled down to sleep on a pile of quilts. So now he was hungry too for many days. So he has gone into the restaurant from where he has taken the food along with some wine followed by sweets. And later on, when he has some sumptuous lunch, dinner, according to his, you can to fill his stomach. Then ultimately what happened? He wanted to sleep. Then he has gone on a pile of quilts where he sat there and slept for some time. So if only Griffin had managed to wake up in good time, all might have been well. As it was, he did not wake up until the assistants were already arriving next morning. So now the problem again arose when, because if he was sleeping for the right time, then it is going to be okay. But the thing is that he was late in waking up. For that, the assistants had arrived into the store. Now they have seen that some man is lying on the quilts, wearing the clothes. Who's that man? They wanted to catch that man. When he saw a couple of them, next page. When he saw a couple of them approaching, he panicked and began to run. So when he saw that those men, they are coming toward him and they are going to catch him, he started running. They naturally gave chase. Naturally it is, but obvious, when a man is running, they would chase him. They would try to catch him. And in the end, he was able to escape only by quickly taking off his newly found clothes. So once more, he found himself invisible but naked in the chill January. So again, he had to protect himself from being caught. What he has done? He has taken off his clothes, thrown it onto the ground. Naturally, again, he is again an invisible man. So with this, you can say he was again an invisible man. Okay, so this is how he has escaped from the London store. So what did Griffin do in order to protect himself from cold weather? Yes, what did he do? Okay, so what he has done there? Okay, he has taken the clothes. So what did Griffin do in the London store? What did he do in the London store? What did he do in the London store? What? Speak in English then. He has stolen the clothes. Okay, and what he did, he wore the clothes in order to protect himself from the cold weather. But what happened? As he was hungry, so what he did, he has entered into the restaurant where he had his meal, some wine, and then followed by sweets. And when it was time for him to take rest, he slept on the quilts, pile of quilts. Was he able to escape from there? How he was able to escape from there? Yes, what he did? Because he was late in waking up, and this before he could be awake, the store assistants or the boys, they have come into the store and they have seen someone sleeping on the quilts. So what they did? They tried to follow him, give him a chase, and ultimately he escaped from there. How he escaped? By taking off his clothes. Okay, by taking off his clothes. Right. So next, this time he decided to try the stock of the theatrical company. So now next time, where he has to go? He has to go to a theatrical company. He thought that in the theatrical company, he will find many things in order to cover his face with. Because his face was the main problem, because people would turn out to be afraid of him if they would see such a invisible man in front of them. Because for the rest of the body, although it is invisible, if it is covered with clothes, no one would come to know that under these clothes, something invisible is there. But the face is the main problem. His nose, his eyes, nothing was visible. And the hat he is wearing to cover his head with, it was hanging up in the air only. So then he decided to try the stock of a theatrical company in the hope of finding not only clothes but also something that would hide the empty space above his shoulders. Shivering with cold, he hurried to Drury Lane, the center of the theater world. So now, as I told you, the next problem for him to cover his face, because it was completely hollow. So for that, he has gone to a theatrical company, which was situated in the Drury Lane. Okay. So we will read in the next lecture or in the next class that what happened in the Drury Lane, why he has gone there, and what he has found there. So that's all for today. If you have any doubts now, you can raise up your hands.